Hey everybody, Dominic here, and in this video I want to introduce you to Canvas Studio and talk about some of the best practices with utilizing Canvas Studio and video in general in your courses. So, Canvas Studio is the video recording platform that we have available to us in Canvas, and all faculty and all students at CBTC have access to use Canvas Studio. Now, how do you get to it? Well, if you log into Canvas and scroll down in the bottom left, you will see a little studio icon. That is how you can access Canvas Studio. And when you click on this icon, it'll bring you to kind of your studio dashboard. In here, you will see any videos that you previously recorded listed in the main area. In the top right corner, you can search for videos by keyword and their name. That you've uploaded in the past. You can add new videos, either a video file that's on your computer, or you can actually add a YouTube link into Canvas Studio. You can also record a new video. In the record area, you have the option if you want to record just your webcam only, or you can do a screen capture of your screen, like what I'm doing now, or a combination of the two. So you have a number of different options in there. I'm going to provide a link down below for the tutorials on how to use Canvas Studio and how to work with all those different features. Now, within your course, you can pull in Canvas Studio videos. So if I go to one of my courses here, I can edit a page, and I'm just going to make this a blank page. And you'll see a little Canvas Studio icon right here. So whether you're making a page, an assignment, a quiz, discussion, you can always pull in a video. So I'll click on the studio icon, and you'll see that I get a smaller version of that same dashboard where I can grab a video. I can choose whether or not to allow comments. Canvas Studio has a really cool feature that I'll show you in a moment about comments. You can also display a download option. This is useful if you have students who off campus, their internet connection is not very reliable. You can give them this download option so that they could download the videos to watch them offline. But then I click on the embed button, and that's going to embed that video into my page. I can scroll down and hit save, and you'll see that now I've got that video embedded on my page. So it's really simple to create a video, put it into Studio, grab it, and then put it into your course so that everyone can see it. And I should mention that everything I've shown you thus far, essentially, a student could also do. Now, there are some really cool features with Canvas Studio. I'm going to go over to our Canvas training course here to demonstrate the commenting feature in Canvas Studio. So if you go on YouTube, there's a comments area where people can leave comments. But a difference between Canvas Studio and that is that if you look at this video right here, notice the blue circles down here on the timeline. These are where people paused the video and left a comment. And if I actually jump forward a little bit here in this video and hit play, you'll see in the bottom right corner, comments will pop up right there. Okay? And I can click on one of those comments and it will jump me down to where that person left the comment and any replies that occurred. So this is really beneficial because essentially what happens is you or your students can leave comments at precise moments in time in the video where that comment is relevant. This is great for giving feedback to students. This is great for students asking questions about the video. So that is a really cool feature of Canvas Studio. In addition to that, oh, I should also mention that in the comments area, there is this little switch to subscribe to comments. You will definitely want to make sure that this is turned on if you want to be notified when students leave comments. If you leave this off, there's the chance that you might end up ignoring your students' comments. So if you're going to use this feature, I would consider turning that on or just make sure that you're really good at checking periodically to see if there are comments. In addition to this, if we go to the Insights tab, we can actually see how much our video has been watched. We have this all viewers view where we can see that, for example, at 20 seconds, I can see 120 people watch this video. If I go way down here, maybe to about 4 minutes, 25 seconds, we have 102 people. So I get this bird's eye view of how much my video is being watched. And I can also click on students. So I can click on Dominic and see that, okay, Dominic watched the whole video. Andrew, okay, so Andrew skipped around a little bit. And so this helps give you some perspective in how much your video is being watched and who is watching it. Another huge benefit of Canvas Studio is the captions. Canvas Studio has a really powerful AI when it comes to recognizing speech and generating captions based upon that speech. So when you record a new video in Canvas Studio, you can request captions to be created. It'll go to work doing its best to create those captions. Once it's done, you can go in and edit and make corrections to the stuff that it didn't get right. But it does a really good job. It's going to save you a lot of time as opposed to using other captioning software or having to do all the captions yourself. So that's another huge benefit of Canvas Studio. One more feature that I want to show you, which is pretty awesome in Canvas Studio, is the quizzing tool. When you create a video and put it into Canvas Studio, once it's up here in your dashboard area, you can click on the little kebab selector and you have this create quiz option. And you can actually create a video quiz that has multiple choice, true, false, and multiple answer style questions. So if there's video content where you'd like students to be able to interact and actually test their knowledge, that's an awesome tool that you can incorporate into your class as well. And again, information about how to do all of that is provided in the guides. Now, some best practices to keep in mind with utilizing video in your course. Well, first of all, we can definitely utilize this kind of tool for lecture capture, okay, where we, as the instructor, are providing instruction to our students. Now, that could just be a webcam recording. Actually, let me get my camera bigger here. That could just be a webcam recording. It could be a screen capture, a combination, but we can provide a lot of the same types of instruction that we would provide if we were in a face-to-face class. That's pretty beneficial. Now, when you're doing this, I highly recommend that you keep your videos under 15 minutes. And to be honest, I would actually make them even shorter than that, maybe under 9 minutes or so. And there's a few reasons for that. Number one, it's just easier to sit through. Consider when you're doing a face-to-face class, if you are lecturing for your students for over 15 minutes, you're going to lose a lot of them. That's a lot of time to spend with you at the front of the class speaking to them and just having them listen. Okay, so we want to break that up. If you have a lot of content to cover, that's fine, but maybe let's not do it all in one giant video. Let's make a smaller video over here. Now let's do an activity where we apply it, and then maybe add some content to that as we go. Could be through another video, could be through some other means. But that's one thing to bear in mind. We don't want our videos to get too long. Another reason to not make our videos too long is that it's easier for you to update. Over time, you may find that some of the information that you provide in an old video is not quite relevant or needs to be changed a little bit. Well, it's much easier to change a 5-minute video than it is to change a 30-minute video. Okay, so that's one thing to keep in mind. And then we also avoid catastrophe because if we make a giant video and we're uploading it, and maybe our internet connection goes out, there's the risk that we're going to lose that giant video that we made. It's much easier to remake a 5-minute video than a half-hour video. So, a few reasons why we don't want to make giant videos in our courses. Another way that we can utilize Canvas Studio is for weekly check-ins. Now, this is something I feel is very important. It is critical to online instruction that we do weekly check-ins. And the basic idea, and it doesn't have to be weekly, I should say. It could be in a shorter time frame than that, maybe longer, but you want to make sure that you are present for your students. We want to increase teacher presence. In a face-to-face class, it's very easy for the teacher to be present. But for an online class, it can often feel like the teacher's not even there. So if you do weekly check-ins with your students where they see you, that increases teacher presence and makes the students feel like you're actually there. You're able to answer their questions. Now, with those check-ins, what can you do? Well, number one, you can motivate your learners. You can recognize the accomplishments that they've had up until this point, and you can also call out the great ideas that they had in a previous week and really say, like, hey, I really liked your contribution to the discussion last week, and call them out by name. I think that's very, very beneficial for students. Also, it gives you a chance to do class-wide feedback. You may find as you're assessing your students that there's certain things that everyone's struggling with. Well, this is a great opportunity to address those things to the entire class rather than doing the same feedback over and over to each individual student. Weekly check-ins are a great way to do that. Lastly, weekly check-ins provide you a means of giving students a preview of what's coming up next week. So I really recommend that you do this. Don't make them too long. Again, I would aim for these, I would aim under 5 minutes. Make them pretty short because you're going to use it once and then you're not going to use this video again. So that's one thing to keep in mind. We can also use Canvas Studio for assignment submissions. Again, students have access to everything that I've shown you here. So you can have students submit their own videos. This is a great way to spur learner-generated content. This is also a way that students could share ideas with their peers. You could have them share their discussions in a common place, like on a discussion. Everyone can post their videos instead of just typing text. So that's another big benefit. The last thing I'll say in regards to utilizing video in your class is we don't want to overwhelm students. Video can be an incredibly useful tool to engage our learners, but just like with any tool, there can be too much of a good thing. We don't want to have a module in which students have to watch 8, 12 different videos. The videos have to be there for a good reason, and we don't want to make things too monotonous. Okay, so consider how video can help to engage your learners in online context. Use it strategically. And of course, if you have questions on how to better utilize video, feel free to reach out to myself or another member of the CPD department. Thanks for watching.